To create a barcode shape, click Shape Tools and then Barcode. The barcode controls will appear in the Smart Bar. From the drop list, choose the barcode type that your customer has requested. The Smart Bar controls will vary according to the selected barcode, and controls will be hidden when they are not supported by the given barcode type. It is expected that your customer has provided you with specific information about how their barcodes should be configured. As an example, consider the controls for this linear barcode, which is composed of vertical bars that are described as either narrow or wide. This setting controls the barcode height. This setting indicates the width of the narrow bars, from which the width of the wide bars is calculated. This is the wide to narrow bar ratio. For example, a ratio of 2.5 to 1 indicates that the wide bars are 2.5 times the width of the narrow bars. The barcode value is entered here. This character picker can also be used, which shows you which characters are allowed for the barcode type. This drop list indicates whether the barcode should be rotated. And the invert button is used to prepare the barcode for reverse applications. If there are additional barcode settings, their controls will appear in this region of the Smart Bar. The specifications for the given barcode will explain how the settings are applied. Click the ellipsis button to include a human-readable caption. For example, this drop list indicates the caption placement, which will be positioned with this offset. However, note that some barcodes have restricted caption placement. When your barcode settings are complete, click Apply, and then click on the workspace to place the barcode object.